My statistics professor of all people told us a joke about some graffiti he saw in a gas station bathroom. Someone wrote, "God is dead, Nietzsche." And below it, someone else wrote, "Nietzsche is dead, God." Funny enough, the second piece of graffiti doesn't make much sense if we really consider what Nietzsche meant by saying God is dead, which is what we'll be exploring today. Howdy friends, it's me, Amy. Now, a lot of atheists really like quoting Nietzsche, and it is true that you find some very strong critiques on Christianity and religion coming from him. However, unfortunately, the phrase "God is dead" is often used incorrectly. Remember my last video on Spinoza? The film I was responding to, "God's Not Dead," didn't really accurately depict what that phrase meant, or really expand upon it at all. But I didn't want to go into it either because the video was on Spinoza and I think the phrase deserves an entire video of its own to fully explain. And that leads us here. So let's start with a little bit of background of the history of philosophy that led Nietzsche to his proclamation. So during the time of scholastic philosophy, mainly during medieval times, the Christian God was in full swing and fully alive, so to speak. You got people like St. Anselm and Thomas Aquinas, and to be transparent with you guys, I haven't really read their philosophy. I'm interested in Anselm, but Aquinas' Summa Theologiae is intimidating to say the least, so if you're well read into scholastic philosophy, then post some resources for us simpletons down in the comments. Anyway, Descartes comes around and kicks off modern philosophy, and now you get thinkers engaged in more epistemological discussions, and God is slowly becoming less relevant. Granted, he's not gone. I mean, Berkeley had God play a role in his epistemology from my understanding, but when you get to thinkers like Hume, you really get God being put into question, so to speak. And now here's Nietzsche, coming after all those guys, proclaiming that God is dead. Not so much in a physical sense, even though Nietzsche was an atheist, but in the sense of the idea of God or the authority of the idea of God. So here's Nietzsche in section 125 of The Gay Science from the Walter Kaufmann translation. "God is dead. God remains dead. And we have killed him. How shall we comfort ourselves, the murderers of all murderers? What was holiest and mightiest of all that the world has yet owned has now bled to death under our knives. Who will wipe this blood off us? What water is there for us to clean ourselves? What festivals of atonement, what sacred games shall we have to invent? Is not the greatness of this deed too great for us? Must we ourselves not become gods simply to appear worthy of it? There has never been a greater deed. And whoever is born after us, for the sake of this deed, he will belong to a higher history than all history hitherto." Now there's a couple important points here to note. Firstly, the tone. It's not super celebratory, and yet it's not regretful. Rather, a feeling that I get is anxiety and suspense. You see, Nietzsche isn't doing some atheist owns Christianity, God doesn't exist sort of thing. He's concerned about humans and their psychology. I mean, I personally see Nietzsche as a very human-centered philosopher. Nietzsche saw a void that God filled. It's a void based on questions of morality, meaning, values, and existence. God was the answer. God was that certainty, that authority, that could comfort you and give you answers. But now, since the Enlightenment and history of philosophy eventually led up to the death of God, what are we to do now as humans? We lost our one true authority on these important life questions. What are we to do now? It's like all those Dawn dish soap ads with a duck being cared for, and now the soap in the hands are yanked away. Wow, that was a stupid example. My apologies. So now what? Now we have this void that's left unfilled in regards to questions of morality, meaning, values, and existence. And probably some other things too. Well, there's a couple of ways this could go. Some people might return to God based on faith in order to fill that void. This is not the route Nietzsche advocates for, but he does talk about this playing out in section 108 of the same book. After Buddha was dead, his shadow was still shown for centuries in a cave, a tremendous, gruesome shadow. God is dead. But given the way of men, there may still be caves for thousands of years in which his shadow will be shown. And we still have to vanquish his shadow too. So what does Nietzsche think we should do with this new void, this new need for meaning? Well, that's a whole other video in itself regarding the idea of the Übermensch, and I want to take it a step at a time here. But think about it yourself. If you're religious, assume that your religion no longer exists for you. And if you're an atheist, keep doing what you're doing, and ask yourself this question. How do I fill the void in my life when it comes to meaning and values? I leave you with this final quote from Nietzsche from the last section of his book, Ecce Homo. that's how you pronounce it. Revaluation of all values. That is my formula for an act of supreme self-examination on the part of humanity. Become flesh and genius in me. It is my fate that I have to be the first decent human being, that I know myself to stand in opposition to the mendaciousness of millennia.